That's a great video for you because we can elevate your interior design and how they look from just a different level. Therefore, watch this video until the end. All this content will be shared within the next 10 minutes, so you will get a lot of knowledge on how to reach this quality. Hello everyone. In this video, we will cover how to do interior design of a contemporary villa, a bedroom, an office with Revit. Please comment below if you have ever used Revit for interior design, and if so, what was the biggest challenge you faced with? We already covered step by step how to do the modern villa in a playlist. We covered the project setup, floor plans, and plumbing in a contemporary villa. So you can click on the pop-up link above or the link in the description above or below, depending on the platform you're watching. Therefore, check them if you did not already. Let's jump into the video. So let's see how we can improve the interior design quality and how we can get better visualization out of the Autodesk sample project. If we go to the living room that they have already created, they did a render, they put some couple of lighting components, a person, fireplace, and a couple of sofas and chairs over here. So we need to see how we can really improve. We can improve in multiple ways. We need to pull better families, we need to play with the texture, we need to play with the lighting, and we need to play with the details. But if you really want to step up your visualization and your demonstration of the interiors, you need to hit the Enscape tab. There is no other way in Revit you get the same quality as Enscape plugin will give it to you. And if I just hit right now run, it will take just a couple of seconds and I will be showing it to you real time. And it's so fast, now I'm almost there, and we will be able to elevate the quality of the interior in like a second. So right now I'm pulling it in front of you and I'm just going very quickly. So you can also see my shortcuts on the right corner over there. So if I just quickly move forward with the keys, and I will be able to see the interior. You see the difference? It's just amazing. I mean, the difference here is just ridiculous. So I would say that there is nowhere close to what we are getting with the Revit. And I'm just going to collapse this so you can see the Revit quality. But it's not that. It's if we just pull it again, the Enscape, and if we just see the details of the chair, for instance, if I zoom in on the chair here, I will be able to see that the details on the chair is quite bad. Bad in the sense is it doesn't have the right attention to detail. It doesn't have the smoothness and the softness of a chair, of a padding. Their details are very straight, so the cuts, all the cuts have to be straight, and this is due to the object-based modeling in Revit. So these are native Revit furniture, and even these furniture, you can see that they are very rigid. You just feel that it doesn't feel right. So if we instead pull, for instance, a chair from Enscape library, you will be able to see that the softness and everything changes radically. And if you use this project, one thing to make, this is just an additional tip, so pay strong attention to that, because this tip will save your life in the future projects. If you are having a split level, please make a view based on that split level. Because if you just do level one and you don't have a view for that living room based outside of that split level, then when you're going to add an object, it will add it onto level one. For instance, if I go to furniture area, and if I try to find a furniture, actually I might be able to find the same chair made in directly, yeah, over here it is. So inside the Enscape, I will rotate it. You can see that it will be placing it at the level one. So if I go to Enscape, I will see it elevated. And that's huge no, because I mean, we don't want that. It is very difficult to work with. Therefore, you need to make a specific view out of that level so you can play and work around Revit. So I would just locate it into manually living room level and go back to the Enscape, and you can suddenly see the details. with one of the worst thing and the best thing with the Enscape is you can see the level of detail, the softness, the padding, the oh my god, it's just awesome in comparison to the chair we have in Revit. But the limitation of the Enscape is that we cannot really play much with the furniture materials. That's a really downside of it, I would say. And another thing, that another limitation, is that on the 2D views, they don't look as good. So I think they need to come up with a solution. And when creating their furniture, they need to draw the outline of the furniture so they can be adopted to the 2D. And we don't want to see the 3D mesh in the 2D environment. So we want to see instead the outline of the components. Therefore, they really need to spend the time and improve their library, how they work with the 2D views in Revit. I think then they will really nail it down. It will be really awesome to play and work and insert. Right now, it's more in visualization purposes. That's why the title of this video is called Modern Interior Design. So we need to go back to the Enscape. You need to use this kind of furniture from Enscape, for instance, or any other reliable source that really fine tunes their furniture and really gets a softness in order to get most out of it. Instead of this rigid sofa, if I choose another sofa from their library, so I can choose one that is good for this living room, it might be, it's loading a bit slow, so I will just choose randomly the one that I saw above. So I will just choose this one, or else I can just choose maybe this couch. All right, so I will just choose this couch and I will just place around here. So I would like to make a comparison. Maybe I can just push it all the way down so you can really compare it. So here, so you can, we can really compare it. If I go back to the Enscape, what happens is, obviously, again, that's what I was mentioning. It's really not convenient to work with if you don't have that split level. I could have done it, but I just wanted to share this experience with you. So what happens here is, look at the suddenly difference, the elevated amount of detail. So it really feels much softer, much greater, and you can really feel attention to detail. Even though it may not fit the interior design of the room, you can even see the details in the padding. It's just amazing. So one of the downsides of the Enscape is the lighting. I think lighting, their lighting components are only for visualization purposes, meaning that you can only see what the icons look like and why the items, how they're designed, but they don't really perform as lighting components. That's one of the biggest downsides, as I believe, from the Enscape side, because if they could really improve their lighting, it would have been amazing. But if you want to get the reliable lighting sources and components and families in Revit, check out our video on the pop-up link above or the link in the description below or above. So you will be able to find our bulk lighting families and our tutorial for ceiling and lighting, how to do and work with lighting design. So lastly, let's just put a lighting component and update the TV potentially. So we will be just going into the floor plan. So let's go and look at the upper side where we have the television and how we can improve that area. For some reason, sometimes it's lagging the search bar. So if it's lagging, what I suggest is, if you type TV, for instance, if it doesn't appear the TV, what I would suggest, and you can see that there's 1,100 items, but I don't think there is one, like all these are TVs. So if you just write tele instead, like a little bit right, a couple of words, and then and go backwards and write TV without deleting the, so tele and going back and TV, writing like this. Yeah, so you need to just play with it in order to get the right search. It sometimes, not always, but you need to keep in mind that. So if I add this one over there on the right hand side, and then I will add the TV unit underneath it. So we will just compare it, how it looks to the existing one. I will be adding the TV unit just next to it. And I will be adding also a lighting component. So I will be deleting all the component area. It's something that gets heavy, I understand that. So I just try to exit and load it again, so in order to speed things up. And I will just put a random interesting lighting, something like this, on the left side. So if we go now on the 3D, when we switch to Enscape, so you can see now how the components are aligning and coming, and you can see the level of detail, and even in the steel detail under the television, it's just a different level, and it's harder to reach with the Revit object modeling. I'm not saying that you cannot find native Revit families that are that quality. Perhaps this quality will be able to find. There are certain level of quality, of softness, but by simply using Enscape, you will be getting loads of value, and your interior design and details will be just at the next level. Look at the comparison. Look at the nighttime as well. If we turn it to the nighttime, so I will be just shifting to the nighttime, and you can see the lighting components appears, how it bounds, the materials bounce the light. It's just great. Obviously the lighting component from the Enscape doesn't have any lighting, as we discussed. And definitely check the video on the left hand side, which is the ceiling design and lighting components, and it showcases a lot of tips and tricks and how to find great lighting components. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, because every week we are sharing a lot of BIM and Revit related content for you. Don't forget to turn your notification bell on. See you next time.